Father, we thank you. You're welcome again to the series, and that is Gleanings from the Book of James. It's been a very wonderful time. Now, to be honest with you, I never knew that we can even cover up to verse 23. I thought we'd still be on verse 6. This is very good. I think it should be the first time we're going to really move fast this way. But great, great, great God. Father, thank you. Thank you for your spirit. We just bless your sweet holy name in Jesus' name. Now, let's read. If any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, is like unto a man building his natural face in a glass. Verse 24, for he buildeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. Now, let's look at the perfect law. That's the theme for this message, perfect law of liberty. Perfect law of liberty. I've told you that I love this book because to me, they are the book of perfection. So you're hearing the word perfect. You can't be looking into the perfect law of liberty and not be perfect. Perfect means mature. Be like Christ. Matthew chapter 5, verse 48. A lot of people argue that. I would say nobody can be perfect. But I believe we can be like Jesus on the earth. We forever need the blood. We forever need mercy. They are new every morning. God's righteousness will still prevail in our life. We still depend on him to make us who he wants us to be. But at the same time, there's a part we have to play. But having played our part, having done all we need to do, we're not going to do it to break forward. We're going to do it to stand, because he's going to be the one to help us. You know, Joshua was a fighter. He fought and fought and fought until God appeared. And when he saw God, you know what Joshua said to God? He said, are you for us or you are for against us? And the Lord of us said, quiet! I am for me. I'm not for you. He said, take off your shoes. Let me give you strategy for Jericho. So we can be like him. Joshua fought and fought. He fought to the intent that he told the son to stand still. He said, son, I don't want you to go down. Perfect law. He commanded the consternation to hold off. Hey, whole testament, no Holy Spirit, no church, no written word except Torah. He was the one that says, this book of law shall not depart of my mouth. Moses told him, but I shall meditate on it, because Moses was the one who wrote the book and handed it over to Joshua for Joshua to be confessing it all the days of his life. Now we have a perfect law of liberty. So now listen, but also looked into the perfect law of liberty, not just looking, and continued therein. So the word of God is likened to a glass. He being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, not the word anymore. So there is doing in the word, and the doing are the doing of the works of the word, the demand of the word. This man shall be blessed, not in some of his deed. Whatever he lays hands supposed to do shall prosper. Blessed is the man that walketh not in counsel with God, in understanding way of sinners, nor sitteth in sin and scoffer. But his delight is in the Lord. His Lord doth meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in the season. His leaf shall not wither whatsoever he doeth. This man shall be blessed in his deed. Why don't you want to be that man? The law you are looking at, the mirror, is the mirror of liberty. You know the word of God sets us free? No, it didn't set us free. It makes us free. You shall know the truth, 14 and 6 John, and the truth that you know shall make you free. If you know 60% of the truth, then you're 60% free. Why can't we dig into the perfect law of liberty regarding every situation of life, marriage, family, righteousness, peace, joy, praise, giving, prosperity, healing, deliverance? Get into that word. It frees man. You can't be in bondage. Oh, God Almighty, bondage. Don't let no man like Galatians come and bound you. He said they come to spy our liberty so they can put us back into the bondage of sin that God has brought us out. Bondage of habits. You, that you have consistent habit that you are yet to leave, of smoking, of weed, of cursing, of immorality, of whatever you call it. I tell you something, man, when you look into the perfect law of liberty under the searchlight of the Holy Spirit, that what is the light of my path, the light of my feet, you know what God will do? He's going to set you free. He's going to set you free. Go there, go there. The only thing the devil will keep from you is the perfect law of liberty, because he wants to keep you in bondage. But the devil is a liar. In the name of Jesus, you're in the bondage of sin, of sickness, of disease, of death, of hell, of shame, of poverty. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I decree your freedom this hour. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Maybe they give you auspice to go and die. Hear me! Thou shalt live and not die. It sets you free. The God that raised Lazarus, Jairus' daughter, oh God Almighty, that put fire in the bones of Elisha, a dead man touched that bone, came back to life. How much more the word that is coming out of my mouth, I decree your healing, your freedom, your deliverance. You become who God wants you to be. You go back to school, you graduate, you can do it. Doors will be open. If you need anything from God right now, I release it to you. Grace for you to go into the world, to have understanding of the word by yourself, for your family. Receive it right now. It is done. Believe God. Trust God. If you mess up, you sin. God is merciful. He's faithful and just to forgive you your sins. Confess your sins. Ask him to come into your heart, to live in you. He give you not second chance. He give you another chance. And he empower you to live right. Be exalted. Be blessed. We continue from there. And God bless you and bless you. Don't forget James chapter 1, 1 through 25. 1 through 25. Read it for yourself, glean some truth out of it, check your back, go to your Bible, get some translations, and you'll see that God is speaking to you through that book. It is well with my soul and with your soul in Jesus' name. Amen.